like about it, he's shooting a very high percentage, 52% from the field and almost 80% from the line. His coaches have encouraged him to get to the rim a lot more frequently. And then you see this stretch over the last five games, 24.5 points, the rebounds up, and shooting 57%.
On the Georgia Tech side, Will Bynum has really picked it up, and with B.J. Elder out, he needed to.
No question, and he has really picked it up from a scoring standpoint, averaging 29 points over his last two games, and against Wake Forest, 30 points, bunch of shots from outside in the perimeter. We know about his ability to put the ball on the floor and carry it all the way to the rim, and the thing that's impressive about him, in his last two games, he has attempted 20 free throw attempts, and combined with Jarrett Jack, they are very explosive, Tim.
Safe to say that we expect the most entertaining game we've had this season tonight.
Get your short spikes out for the track meet.
It's going to be a lot of fun. The fans are ready, and so are we. We'll be right back.
From the fastest and strongest to the most capable and most powerful Dodge Ram trucks. Matched by none, envied by all.
Come on, man, floor it!
Grab 0+, 0% financing plus package discounts plus January bonus cash for total savings up to $9,100.
Describe the perfect day, Liz.
Well, we're driving to the lake, the kids watch a DVD, and Joe and I have some quality time.
Joe?
Okay, we're barreling along. The Hemi's kicking some serious butt. Then we fish.
Ah, see? You're not traveling in the same vehicle.
The all-new Durango. Big size, smooth ride, Hemi power.
What a quack.
Grab 0+, 0% financing plus great package discounts plus January bonus cash for total savings up to $88.50.
Mowers. Coppers. Flaggers. Shooters. And a little bit of how's your father. Fancy a butcher's, rated M for mature.
We welcome you back to College Park, Maryland, here at the Comcast Center. The 22nd ranked Jackets against the Terrapins. As we mentioned, Georgia Tech coming off a very emotional overtime victory over Wake Forest at the Alexander Memorial Coliseum. And B.J. Elder was the number one fan of Jarrett Jack. And after the game, when they stopped Chris Paul, and it was clearly his worst night of the ACC season, hugs and kisses abound for their leader, Jarrett Jack. Paul Hewitt is standing by with Dwayne Ballard.
Thanks, Tim. Coach Hewitt, that was one of the greatest games of the season, that victory. What did you learn about your team after that game?
Really, we've started to play better basketball. That's all I knew is that, you know, after our Virginia Tech game, after reviewing the tape, I thought we were playing a little better, and we carried it over into that game. With that said, we've got to play well again here tonight.
Now, today at shoot-around, notice B.J. Elder was actually shooting, not as part of practice, but does that mean that he's going to be involved at some point soon?
No, it's still indefinite. He's just trying to make some baby steps coming back. We don't want to rush him back because if he aggravates that, it could be a long time before he sees the court again.
And finally, what concerns you tonight as you head out on this court? Maryland also coming off of a very big victory.
You've got another team. We feel like we're building some confidence. Maryland feels like they're building some confidence. And I know it's going to be a very hard-fought game. In the past, we've had some trouble on the boards with them. We've got to do a better job on the backboards.
Thank you, Coach Hewitt. Coming up, folks, ACC Sunday Night Hoops tip-off between the Yellow Jackets and the Maryland Terrapins. Straight ahead.
Hey, Teddy, can you come in here and do some rebates for me?
Sure.
Actually, sir,
my biological dad, who I haven't seen in 20 years, just showed up. And he really wants to take me for ice cream, so...
Teddy,
yeah.
You know we have an easy button now, right?
We have an easy button?
When it comes to rebates,
Larry, Dave,
everybody has an easy button. It's called Staples. Just go online. There's no clipping, no mailing, no hassles. What's easier than that? Staples. That was easy.
ACC Sunday Night Hoops is presented by Staples. That was easy. And brought to you in part by Nike Pro Apparel. By Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns, Dodge. And by Harley Davidson Motorcycles. It's time to ride. It's time to play here at College Park, Maryland at the Comcast Center. The spotlight on these two outstanding teams that are coming off very big victories. Paul Hewitt, 41 years young, Jamaican born, and came over from Siena and took his team to the national championship game a year ago. And there's his starting five, McHenry, Muhammad, Schincher, who they really want to see more productivity from, particularly tonight, Bynum and Jack, the world-class backcourt. And there you see where Gary Williams ranks. Among ACC coaches in career victories, he's moving up the ladder in a hurry, just past Terry Holland, as everyone knows. We'll take a look at the Staples starting five for his Terps. And Will Bowers, who he told us a week ago was very close to becoming a starter, has done just that. Was in the Duke game, gets the call again tonight to go along with Garrison and McCray, and no doubt Gilchrist the leader. And I think it's going to be outstanding to see what happens. Look at the Dodge game plan.
Well, for Georgia Tech, you want to limit the offensive rebounds of Maryland, low turnovers, and for the Terps, they want to continue that defensive intensity that they found down in Durham, and they want to eliminate that third scorer. They know that Bynum and Jack are big-time scorers. They want to keep somebody else from coming up and hurting them.
Schincher flashes to the post. No double team. Bowers with him, and he takes advantage.
Yeah, you know, we were talking to them and trying to get Schincher involved early, a big key. And I don't think, you know, he has not been as dominant this year as he was last year, Tim.
McCray has it rejected. Now Bynum, who certainly can create his own shot. Jarrett Jack with the dump down to Schincher again. Muhammad, a pull-up. Rebound to Garrison.
Right, I think that shot right there bails out Kaner Medley. They feel like they can take him off the dribble, and when Muhammad shoots jump shots, it plays into Maryland's hands.
Kaner Medley. Oh, he's been singing quite a tune, his own medley of late.
You know, it's and he is in a zone right now, a serious zone on the offensive end, Tim. And it's amazing to watch a player blossom like that. Great movement without the basketball. His teammates are doing a terrific job of finding him and finding him just too late.
Steps on McHenry as we come back the other way. Maryland, a 4-0 after defeating Duke, so clearly they get pumped up after beating the Devils. And perhaps other than North Carolina, since Gary Williams claimed the national championship in 02, that's really become the rivalry in the ACC, other than Duke, Carolina, outside the triangle.
Well, Carolina will always be the main rivalry because of Maryland's ascendancy and where they've gone, and they've been to two Final Fours and won a national championship. It's only natural that those two.
Harrison uses the window. 5-2 Terrapins. Bynum. Garrison clears it. Gilchrist looking to push.
quickly doubled, gives it up to Gilchrist. Rebound to Muhammad. Is Ramona running? Muhammad all the way to the cup.
Most important thing to do in the break is stop the advance of the basketball. Maryland did not do that with Muhammad.
McCray. The other thing about these guards, Mike, some of them shoot the ball much better in transition. Jack leaves it for Center. Tough shot, and he actually made it tougher. Muhammad the pick. Ismail Muhammad, so explosive.
I tell you, that is a matchup that is very troublesome to Maryland. Ismail Muhammad has got the athletic ability to stay with Kaner Medley out on the perimeter. Georgia Tech in a good matchup zone right now. We're going to see Maryland prove themselves from the perimeter.
McCray on the wing.
Look at it, Maryland has made fewer threes than anybody in the league right now, and I think that's what Georgia Tech wants to test here early.
Garrison, nice look to Kaner Medley, wide open. Well, if there is a Terrapin that can hit from downtown, it's the guy with the hyphen.
And you look at it, and that was a great play in the way it unfolded because they explored the interior first. They got it into Garrison. They make that zone collapse, and then he knew exactly where Kaner Medley would be, flared out along the baseline.
Six already for him. Air ball thrown up.
That's only his sixth three of the year, Tim, and it is not a good shot for Ismail Muhammad.
There's a steal by Jack. Gilchrist on his hip. Wise move to let him go.
And a lazy pass out from Maryland. You know, if the ball gets stolen right there, that's an automatic 2 points. Jared Jack is like a cornerback on that play, sniffing out the screen pass.
Gilchrist with the dump down to Bowers. Medley this time off the front iron. Schencher the rebound. Bynum goes crossover. Oh, what a floater. Off the front rim. Garrison fouled by Muhammad. Paul Hewitt.
His team played that incredibly long overtime period. How rare is it to think of Chris Paul and Jarrett Jack each missing two free throws during that overtime? Of course, Jack did get the last two with 4.4 seconds remaining. And I think fatigue may be a factor considering all the difficulty in travel.
Right, if they had come up yesterday, I'd agree, but Georgia Tech switched their travel plans, came up Friday night, so they were up here, they were in good shape, and had 2 days really to rest.
Georgia Tech turns it over. Muhammad playing with some authority early around the hoop. But Nick Kaner Medley is also playing big. We're early and it's fast.
It's about that time again. Taxes. But the friendly folks at Cashland have given them somewhat of a makeover. Made things quicker and easier. Bring us your refund check and have cash in hand in minutes. Or you can start at Cashland and have us prepare and file your taxes. Then collect on your refund in as little as a day in cash. Taxes may be forever, but the wait for your refund shouldn't be. Call Cashland for details and locations. It's another way we're your cash carrier.
Make a smooth approach. Make smooth contact with Electric Shave Pre-Shave Lotion. Stands up whiskers for up to a 52% closer shave. Electric Shave. Blade close, electric smooth.
When I had a cold sore, I wouldn't leave my cube. But then my pharmacist recommended Herpesin L. It helps heal cold sores fast. Moisturizers help prevent cracking. And it even has SPF 30. Herpesin L, every day.
I can't believe I owe this much money.
Now I'm even scared to answer the phone in our own home.
Community Credit Counseling Corporation understands, and we can help you solve your problems. We'll help reduce your repayment time by up to 75% and lower those high interest rates to as little as 0%.
I'm on the road to reestablishing my credit and my life.
Whether you owe thousands or hundreds of thousands in credit card debt, call the toll-free number on your screen for more information. Get your life back.
This is the
the Sports List.
With Summer Sander.
The show that counts down anything
and everything
in the world of sports.
The Sports List, weeknights on FSN.
We welcome you back. Let's flash back to the 2000 season in College Park when then-sophomore point guard Juan Dixon put on an incredible show. The future all-time leading scorer for the Terrapins had a career-high 33 en route to their runaway victory. And yes, it left the coach of the Yellow Jackets of Georgia Tech at that time, Bobby Crimmins, with a look as though he were destined for broadcasting.
Juan was an incredible scorer, and I knew from that moment on he would be tough to coach against, and as I thought, he became a great player.
Juan hit 4 of 5 three-pointers in that game, led the Terps in scoring and steals for three seasons, and you know, he and LaRon Propick and Blake were all here to help pump up the Terrapins before that Duke game.
Well, it's amazing, Tim, that he was not a great player when he got to Maryland, redshirted, only averaged, I think, 6 or 7 points as a freshman, but then really blossomed after that, and Gary Williams has had a knack for finding players like that. Lonnie Baxter, another one of those guys on that championship team who was not a top 10 prospect coming out of high school.
Painter Medley can't hit. There's a push spotted against Maryland. I believe Obikwe may have picked it up.
So far, a point of emphasis for Georgia Tech. We touched on it at the top. They are concerned greatly about Maryland's ability to offensive rebound the basketball, but so far, Tech doing a nice job of keeping Maryland off the glass.
Right at the top of the show, Paul Hewitt telling our Dwayne Ballen just that. Bynum raises the rim on the run out a big way, but they miss him. Gilchrist finds McCray. That's a block against Bynum. Not underneath him, says Bob Donato. This is a veteran crew led by Bob and Carl Hess and Jim Haney tonight in the Atlantic Coast Conference.
And this is one of the things that's a little, you know, puzzling to me about McCray. 12 points a game, but he's 91% from the free throw line, second in the conference, but he's only got 44 attempts, Tim. He's taken fewer attempts than anybody else in the top 10. Now, if I'm shooting 91%, I want to go to the line as much as possible, and I think the coaching staff wants him to be more aggressive in trying to attack the rim.
Well, you pointed out before the game tonight the difference in Kaner Medley in terms of his overall game. Gary Williams wanted him to get more aggressive, and he did so, and scored a lot more by getting to the free throw line.
And that's, you know, that's how I don't know in the history of the game a great scorer who hasn't gotten to the free throw line 8 or 9 times a game.
McHenry just blows past Terrapins to get a layup, and Gary Williams fuming over that.
Well, his concern is defensively. His team has not been a good first half defensive ball club, except they were down at Duke, and that's why they came out with a win.
Obikwe follows it. Now we'll go against Georgia Tech. Kenny Obikwe staying tough and is fouled by Luke Schincher.
Obikwe is another guy who has seen his free throw numbers really increase. He's had 17 attempts his last two games. Tim, he really factored heavily in that win down in Durham. A big last minute of that ball game, and had a key layup on an underneath out of bounds play that gave them the go-ahead points.
Dickey coming onto the floor now for Tech, and Kist for Maryland. James Gist is one of those high-flying athletes, young player that can really make a difference around the basket particularly.
And, you know, you put a guy like that in here, he can't get into the game slowly. You want him going 65 miles per hour. You want him going the speed limit immediately, which is a tough thing to do for a freshman coming off the bench.
Sean Dickey for Georgia Tech, number 4, down in the block in front of a Obikwe. Jack had the pick from Dickey. And finally the roll. He was there. It just was a slow developing pick and roll.
Well, Obikwe had to come over and help on that drive, and that's what left Dickey alone inside.
Is that the longest pick and roll you've ever seen executed?
Pick and roll.
They were moving at my baby boomer speed. Gilchrist asking for clear out, and he gives it to Obikwe. That was a poor decision trying to go through two Jacket defenders. Bynum lost his dribble and a reach-in foul. And I believe Bynum and Kaner Medley were getting with it. A little extracurricular activity. We're talking about those assists. Well, Jarrett Jack, it should bear out that he is one of the all-time most physical point guards you'll ever find. And Raymond Felton obviously has had an incredible year from North Carolina. Abekwe brings it down.
And what neither coach wants is this devolving into a matchup and a battle between Gilchrist and Jack.
Kaner Medley. Don't enjoy it too long, because Ismail Mohammed will beat you down the floor in a hurry.
Well, you want to talk about something that gets Gary Williams or any coach's ire up. You hit a jump shot, you don't have defensive balance down the other end, and the team gets a layup on a made basket.
Nick Kaner,
we have a look at it.
This time, not there. Out of bounds to Georgia Tech. Kaner Medley in rhythm, knocking it down. There you see the story from three-point range. Georgia Tech an 0-for right now. McHenry just inside the arc. Abekwe the rebound. Now posting up, Kaner Medley gets his man airborne. Boy, just in so many different ways. He has 11 of the Terps 18.
That's amazing what Coppins is, and that ball's going to go the other way. Good defense by the Terrapins, but Kaner Medley, you can see the zone that he is in, not only hitting the three, but the ability to post up inside as well.
He has just become almost unguardable. And I don't see any ill effects from that angle.
Now, I talked to him beforehand. He was just more afraid. It was, like I said, it was the same ankle that he dislocated in the NCAA playoffs. And you know, for a left-handed player, it's his left ankle, so it's not his jumping ankle. It's not that critical, but he seems to be fine.
Alina, and a foul. McCray can really get hot. So too can Gilchrist. No question about that.
Well, John Gilchrist, he is much better. He has to get his shoulders by you to beat you. And I love players who use the glass from that angle.
McCray leads the game. And Jones checks in for him. Bynum picking up his second foul.
And we've touched on it, Tim, that John Gilchrist is better when he's concerned about Maryland winning. And he is going to get more notoriety when Maryland wins.
To me, this is the ultimate matchup. The two most physical point guards in the conference and probably in the country.
Well, and then you'd have the converse of that would be the speed of Chris Paul against Raymond Felton. But you're right, and it's a perfect strength-on-strength matchup.
Loose ball taken out of there by... I believe that was Rashawn Dickey that was down on the floor. The arrow is pointing to the Terps, so they'll have it when we come back from the scrum.
Dude, what do you got in that thing?
I got an amp, guitar, surfboard, ladder, and 12 2x4s.
Velocity meets versatility. The all-new Hemi-powered Dodge Magnum. Open it up from either end.
This winter, grab the new 2005 Dodge Magnum and save big with $1,000 in January bonus cash now at your Dodge dealer.
Hey, nice Harley.
Yeah. Yeah. Had to get it, you know? It's great. It's the way I live my life, you know? By my own rules. Well, that's my creed or motto. My credo, you know?
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, I like to live like by the edge of my... Can you believe the crime in this town? It's crazy. It's like broad daylight right in front of us. It's like, hello, it's my bike, miss.
Maybe you should get your own. How far can inspiration take you?
Can available all-wheel drive take you through any season? Can a 340-horsepower Hemi take your breath away? And can the ultimate luxury sports sedan take you all the way to the top? Looks that way, the 2005 Motor Trend Car of the Year, the Chrysler 300, starting at $23,995. Chrysler, inspiration comes standard.
If you talk to anyone at Georgia Tech about B.J. Elder, they will say that there's really no timetable on when he may return, but we do see a noticeable difference with and without B.J. Elder to Georgia Tech.
Well, you see the big number is the difference in opponents scoring, and that number is skewed a little bit because a lot of that high scoring is in the ACC and better competition. But I think the big key for him is he's so important in their half-court offense. He gives them another guy out on the perimeter, obviously, and he doesn't do a lot off the dribble, which I think helps Luke Schencher.
As we come back, here's Gilchrist leading it for Kaner Medley. Kaner Medley takes it down to the blocks. Dwayne Ballin has more on the B.J. Elder factor.
Tim, I was talking to B.J. before the game, and he told me the toughest part during this being out has been watching the losing streak. And he says what he's become is a coach, an adjunct coach for Will Bynum and for Jarrett Jack. He notices things, and I asked him if they listened to him. He said they did. He admits that he will have to get his wind back when he comes back. But, G-Man, you won't be surprised at this. He says his shot never went away, so it'll be there when he returns.
No, hey, Dwayne, my shot never went away, but everything else did. I mean, that was the problem. And, you know, for B.J., you know, he's an adjunct coach now. They'll listen to him, but when he becomes a real coach, that's when they'll tune him out.
Yes, exactly.
Does not fall for Anthony Morrow. He and Mario West have come on the floor for Georgia Tech out of the timeout. And Dickey also out there. Kaner Medley again, trying to go reversal. Yes, there's that activity we talked of, how quick he is around the basket. We'll get a lot of garbage points before his career is done.
A very quick jumper, and a lot of that is because of Kaner Medley and his aggressiveness inside. And Georgia Tech really scrambling on the interior defensively. Nobody really in blockout position. And you have got to get a body on Gist.
I can see the numbers on the boards, and clearly the advantage they had against Duke. They out-rebounded the Blue Devils by eight Wednesday night. It's carried over into the next game against Georgia Tech.
Well, and they are the number one rebounding team in the conference, and that has really been a trademark of Gary Williams' teams over the years. Very strong on the glass. They like that the big front line, especially when running that flex offense.
And a freshman from Silver Spring, Maryland, and good counsel. High school gets the free throw, 22-14. Garrison back on the floor, replacing him. Morrow got hot, hit 3 3-pointers against Wake Forest, but has yet to produce in road games for Georgia Tech. Dickey, that's a nice move by Rashawn.
That's the last place a freshman usually excels. He finds that comfort level at home, and then he's got to get used to going out on the road in a hostile environment and shooting the ball, especially if you're a three-point specialist.
Jones working on Jack. Bickway. Kenny Bickwe. That's always some valuable gravy for their offense when he gets warm. 5 points and 4 rebounds. Paul Hewitt gets a timeout. Well, this year, expect the unexpected as Fox Sports brings the Super Bowl party to your house. JB and the guys will be in Jacksonville with in-depth interviews, analysis, performances from Kelly Clarkson, the Black Eyed Peas, and more. The next best thing to being at the game, Hawks NFL Sunday, Super Bowl 39 pregame, February 6th at 2 Eastern, 11 Pacific, only on Fox.
We'll be in-state, but a little farther north.
Yeah, we will. During the week, actually, I'm going to get to see JB. We both have radio shows on the same network, so I'll have a chance to get the lowdown from James Brown, who makes his home in the D.C. area.
Any more? You want to get another plug about your radio?
Well, I just happened to mention it's one of those things. We're colleagues, as they say.
Just came out of conversation, yeah. That's all.
We're colleagues, as they say.
Jack for three.
You know, I really like the shots that these teams have been getting. That time out, the dribble penetration by Muhammad, very much under control like he was against Wake Forest.
Loose ball. And I believe Morrow was out of bounds. He was. So we were talking to Jarrett Jack before the game. He came over to chat with us, and he had some of the homeboys, as they say, from Maryland wishing him well. This, of course, is, we mentioned, D.C. This is always a home game for Jarrett Jack. Sam Frederick has come into the game for Anthony Morrow. A big way.
Jarrett Jack actually came to a game here, a Maryland game over the Christmas break. He was home from Georgia Tech. Came to check out, do a little scouting.
There's the dump down to Dickey. Frederick can also load up from downtown. That's the physical nature. This is a wonderful matchup to watch. With the clock winding down, Jack a runner. Too strong, and Dickey over the back of Obikwe will pick up the foul.
Well, Jarrett Jack, he got the shot that he wanted. It was a good screen roll up the top, and he was able to get by Gilchrist. And both of those guys have shown the ability to shoot that little floater in the lane.
Number four, Rashawn Dickey, his first, seventh on the team.
That's the seventh team foul, so bonus time for Obikwe.
I saw you talking to the people at Georgia Tech, and they talked about the Wake Forest game. The Wake Forest got into the bonus at the 12-minute mark of the first half and at the 10-minute mark of the second half, and they were still able to overcome that.
A lot of players were in foul difficulty very early in that game and were non-factors. And a return to sender as Garrison goes up the back on that free throw attempt. Just the 15th foul against Maryland, so Georgia Tech will inbound.
And,
by being in the bonus that early, it should benefit Maryland, one of the best free throw shooting teams in the conference.
Wave it off. That is a foul that will go against Maryland. And Gary Williams is a little incensed by that. Obikwe picked it up. And Nick Kaner-Medley will come in for Jones. Goes against Jones rather than a big way.
Well, you're going to see when Mike Jones is in the game, teams, especially guards, are going to attack him off the dribble.
Bynum back on the floor, replacing Frederick. Hey, McCray's doing a nice job shadowing Will Bynum. We haven't heard much from him. Muhammad working over Kaner-Medley. McHenry with the follow.
Well, Tony McHenry really just does all the dirty things for this team, all the dirty work. He's got his hard hat on all the time. Great offensive rebound.
That's a player control foul. It'll go the other way. Good defensive work by Dickey. Obikwe been out of control there.
There's a look, and that's, you know, that's not a play that he should be making off the dribble like that. A big, that's just inviting somebody to step up underneath you and draw the charge.
Will Bowers comes in for him. Interesting to watch the development of Bowers, because Gary Williams is very high on him, believes against certain teams in difficult matchups in the post, he can be a factor. Jack with the jump stop, giving it up. Bynum. Every attempt has been under duress for Will Bynum.
McCray, you talked about his defense earlier. McCray has got the length to give Bynum a little bit of room and cut off the dribble and still get out and bother the shot. So it's a good combination defensively.
Bynum is 0 for 4. Shot clock at 10.
McCray, and that's going to be a hand check against Jarrett Jack.
Well, the thing they like about Will Bowers, he's one of the true low post players that Maryland has. And in Gary Williams' offense, that's a necessity. They like his ability to catch, and he seems like he's had a good ability here to catch and not force things, to pick out things back out on the perimeter, kick it out, and reestablish possession.
Well, I thought Jarrett Jack had picked up that foul, and so did Paul Hewitt. But Carl Hess called it on Bynum, and that's his, I believe they got, I think they announced Bynum. And I think Paul Hewitt is disturbed by it. I think they changed it to Will Bynum, and if so, that's... That is a foul, I believe, logged against Will. And that's what Paul Hewitt is upset about. I think Jarrett Jack would prefer getting the foul. And Paul Hewitt would have preferred.
Jack put his hand up and tried to take one for the team right
there.
Yes,
he did. So that's three fouls on Will Bynum. And that's crucial. Paul Hewitt knows it. 28-21, Terrapins by 7.
And now we have to get to our traffic report. Let's do that. How about that traffic report?
Traffic is horrible this morning. I get the feeling.
People are trying to get to work this morning.
Speaking of
introducing the Acura RL with the first real-time traffic monitoring system through AcuraLink. It can help you find an open road. And with 300 horsepower and the world's most advanced all-wheel drive, it knows what to do when it gets there.
We're really trying to get you the traffic.
Oh, you know what? My mother forced me to take that in.
The all-new Acura RL.
Mowers. Coppers. Blaggers. Shooters. And a little bit of how's your father. Fancy your butchers. Rated M for mature.
Five, put it in hot to the target.
Until now, you needed a luxury sedan for this kind of room and comfort. Until now, you needed an SUV for command seating and a better view of the road. Until now, you'd have paid twice as much for a sedan like this with all-wheel drive. In fact, Ford 500 SE goes from 0 to 60 faster than the Chrysler 300 Touring. Now you can lease the all-new Ford 500 for just $259 a month with a maintenance package at no extra charge. Ford 500, built for the road ahead.
Saturday, Pac-10 College Hoops returns to the floor when UCLA tries to pull the upset. They battle 10th-ranked Washington. Coverage begins at 5 Eastern, 2 Pacific. Washington beat Arizona State today by 9. That should be an entertaining game. We look forward to that action and more. Maryland by 7. 7:52 remaining, and Will Bynum now saddled with 3 fouls. That may be one of the real crucial points of the first half, is picking up the third rather than Jack.
Now the onus falls on Anthony Morrow to be that other perimeter shooter out of the floor along with Jarrett Jack. Let's see if Jack becomes more aggressive.
Gilchrist lost his dribble, and then the reach-in foul is tagged against Sterling Ledbetter, the junior college transfer from Allegheny Community College, just into the game.
Tim, right now this lead has been fashioned by Maryland at the free throw line, where they are 7 of 10. Georgia Tech has yet to attempt a free throw in this game. And point of fact, too, that Maryland is out shooting Tech from behind the three-point line.
Ismail Muhammad will get to the free throw line. The other thing that we've noticed is the game bogged down after a very fast-paced start. It's become more of a grinder and has turned into a more of a half-court game. I guess missed shots have something to do with that. You see what Bynum has meant the last two games, and he's 0 for tonight.
Just a bit of a drop-off there.
Returning to the Terrapins, number 11, John Gilchrist.
Muhammad has certainly been a factor. He has 8, keeping the road team in it. Ledbetter again loses his dribble.
Interesting. Georgia Tech with Ledbetter in the game along with Gilchrist, deciding to put some full court pressure on, and it results in a turnover.
Muhammad defended well by Gilchrist. He knocked it out. Sam Frederick just into the game will trigger it in. Jonas Tarver also on the floor now for Georgia Tech. Big number 44. Giving it up to McKinley. Jack over Gilchrist. Travis Garrison brings it down.
Five rebounds for him. Interesting, when the ball doesn't go through the cylinder, it does at times slow the game down. Both teams struggling a bit to score.
Well, I think, you know, you play on the road, and Georgia Tech is going to be very concerned about their transition defense. So even on a miss, if they have good balance, they're going to be able to get back.
McHenry off the bounce. Hayner Medley, another rebound.
Gilchrist will do it himself. That's the old number one play. I'll bring it down, call one, and shoot.
Me, myself, and I. And John, if he hasn't had a good look in a while, he'll do that, especially in transition. We saw it in the second half against NC State last week.
Muhammad taking it right to Kaner Medley and draws the foul.
Now, I talked about that in the opening minutes of the game, and I think that Ishmael Muhammad has been bailing out Kaner Medley to a degree. There's no reason why he shouldn't be able to put the ball on the floor and do that against him. And the best defense against Kaner Medley is to get fouls on him and get him over on the bench.
Wholesale substitutions now for Georgia Tech. Mario West coming onto the floor. Tarver leads, Frederick and McHenry. Also Rashawn Dickey. And Anthony Morrow are back.
Returning to the Yellow Jackets.
A very deep Georgia Tech team. And we haven't seen Chincher in quite some time.
And 23, Anthony Morrow.
That's a rejection, two of them by Morrow. Outstanding defensive sequence.
Again, why take that shot in that situation, Tim? You don't have numbers. There's board coverage for Maryland.
Ledbetter. Finger roll by Sterling. And it was just that.
Muhammad can't get it to fall, and the foul will go against Mario West.
And you get the feeling that Georgia Tech is just trying to force the tempo, and offensively they've maybe rushed some shots because of it.
Well, I had too many jump shots for Georgia Tech, and especially with buying them out. I mean, it's one thing if he's rolling, which he's not, but absent that, I think you've got to make a little bit more concerted effort, at least do something off the dribble and get the referees involved in this game and get yourself to the free throw line.
Gilchrist just under 70% on the year.
I think he got the message from his coach a few weeks back. Has played much better recently. Tanner Medley sits down, and Jones comes back onto the floor.
And you know, it showed at Duke that he does not have to have a monster offensive night for this team to win. He gets 9 rebounds in that game. But you know, talking to their coaching staff, he set the tone emotionally for that game, especially on the defensive end, and that was the most important thing that Gilchrist did in that game, and that's why they come out of there with a W.
Dickey really wants it. He's got Bowers on him. McHenry needs some help. West, the runner. Oh, a whirling dervish scoop to the hoop by Mario.
That was a Mario deuce.
Well, he's been great, and we've seen his role expand. And look in here, you see the L, it'll just open up and go inside. Bowers playing off the screen a little bit. Everybody kind of leaves the man with the basketball, and I don't care if you have respect for his offensive ability or not. You do that, you give him that type of room, he's going to be able to get to the front of the rim.
He also got a bit of a moving pick that he took advantage of. One of those,
Jerry Kramer kind of holding guard.
Jones not there. And the rebound by West. And a quick foul. I believe Jones will pick it up.
That'll be his second.
And just what you described, play harder on the defensive end, maybe get the officials involved. That's what Georgia Tech has done.
It's 10 team fouls now against Maryland with 5:08 remaining.
And this has been an up and down shooting free throw team in Georgia Tech. And one of the big reasons why they beat Wake Forest in overtime, 31 of 38 from the free throw line, which is a good shooting night for this ball club.
The Duke game and what John Gilchrist meant in that game. Jarrett Jack is sitting down right now as you see Zan Frederick coming in. Georgia Tech got a breakthrough win at Duke last year too, en route to making it all the way to the title game in the NCAA tournament. The ingredients to beating a Mike Krzyzewski coach team at Cameron, you had better have a physical point guard.
Right, and be physical in general. These are teams that have been successful and gone in there and win. And, you know, for Paul Hewitt, that's really the makeup of his backcourt. He likes big, strong guards. And B.J. Elder, Ishmael Muhammad, his first couple of recruits, Jarrett Jack, all are really strong.
Gilchrist over Frederick. Dickey had it, and a nice move by Harris in the middle call of jump ball. Brown wanted a foul. We talked to John Gilchrist about understanding his role as a point guard, and this is what he told us.
As point guards, you have trouble knowing that you can take over at any time, but, you know, if you can't get caught up in your game so much that you have to make sure that everyone on your team is clicking and flowing, because, I mean, a team can easily devise a plan to stop one guy, you know. So that's what a true point guard is all about, getting everyone on the floor playing the best ball they can play. Because if you have a lot of options, then that just makes the team hard to stop.
Mario West with the deuce. I believe he said that just the way his coach would like him to verbalize it. Right on cue, he uses the glass.
I didn't know if that was John Gilchrist or Gary Williams that we were listening to.
Jack. Dickey the follow. Well, you knew Jarrett Jack, after what Gilchrist just did, was going to take it right back and try to make something happen.
Well, it's again, I mean, he talked about not getting into a battle one-on-one here, but you see in the last couple of possessions these two slipping into that.
Nice pass to a big way. West is late getting there. He picks up the foul. 3:52 remaining. These two super guards on display on Sunday Night Hoops.
Hey! 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 Up under, sideways down. Backwards, forwards, square and round. Under, sideways down. Backwards, forwards.
Introducing the new commotion in the Chevy family. The Cobalt Coupe, Sedan, and SS Supercharged. Chevy Cobalt, an American revolution.
Seit 1873 wird Beck's strikt nach den Richtlinien des deutschen Reinheitsgebots von 1516 gebraut. Es sind die Qualität der Zutaten.
You don't have to understand German.
Detail, denen Beck's all you need to know is Geschmack verdankt.
A, you are not in Germany. B, Germans understand beer. The number one German beer in the world. Life beckons, and you're holding the key.
Some people are born negotiators. Some aren't. At eLoan, we'll help you get the right loan at the lowest possible rate, based on your credit score, not your negotiating skills. Apply now at eLoan.com.
It's the best damn Super Bowl roadshow, period. Tom and Sal shift into high gear with Michael Strahan along for the ride. Jacksonville will be jumping when Leanne Sweeten turns the town upside down.
Let's go, girls!
It's a week filled with legends of the game, today's top guns, and stars of the silver screen. Then, live on Super Bowl Sunday, the guys host the world's largest Super Bowl tailgate party on Fox. the best damn Super Bowl roadshow, period, all week long, this week on FSN.
Hi again, everybody. I'm Mike Goldberg. Coming up on the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show, I'll be joined by the vet Larry Conley, the coach Perry Clark. Nearly February, and Gene Katie and Purdue still pursuing their first Big Ten conference victory. And top 20ers UConn and Oklahoma State take their shows on the icy roads. It's all coming up on the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show. Back out to the Comcast Center, College Park, Maryland. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski, Dwayne Ballin, Timmy B.
All right, Mike, and I'm happy to see that Larry Conley, my friend, from Florida into Atlanta. I'm happy that all of us made it to our respective locations for tonight's game. Take a look at our Elon first half stat of the game. We talked about Tech's concern on the boards. Paul Hewitt had it, and for good reason.
And Maryland has been very active on the glass, plus 10 there. Five of those 22 are offensive rebounds, so you combine that with 46% shooting, and as many times as Maryland has gotten to the free throw line, they've had pretty good offensive productivity in the first 16 minutes of this game.
A big wave from Carson, California. Very athletic. Everyone knew he would be an outstanding shot blocker, and that's what he's been, one of the best in the league. But he's really improved on the offensive boards. Hit several big free throws against Duke. Everyone matters, particularly when you're a former and indoor stadium. Which, by the way, will be the sign of game two of ACC Sunday Night Hoops tonight. Virginia Tech will be in to take on the Blue Devils.
Between Garrison and Abekwe in that last minute down in Durham, they combined for 9 of 10 from the free throw line. Now, Garrison, you'd expect to be solid, but Abekwe at only 60%, so that should have given him a lot of confidence with his free throw stroke. A packed in, real tight zone by Maryland down this trip down.
One of the reasons that the flow of this game changed, missed shots and then both teams going to zone defenses, understanding that they were cool from the perimeter.
Well, with Bynum out, they want to test other people from outside. And
West with an air ball, but Morrow steps up and dumps it in.
See, now, if you're Mario West, that was an assist. That was not an air ball.
By the way, the Georgia Tech bench, Mike, really keeping them in it. They have a combined 13 points and 4 rebounds from Dickey and West alone.
Well, when a guy like Bynum goes out, others have to step up, and the bench was a huge key for Georgia Tech in last year's push through the NCAA tournament.
Hayner Medley with a turnaround. Oh, the shooter's touch. There you see the bench point story, and
he's been quiet, though. That's his first basket in about 10 minutes.
Yep. 13 for Hayner Medley. His most recent hoop, to be sure.
The turnover by Dickey that time, and he had really predetermined what his move was going to be before he read the defense, and a nice double team by Garrison and Hayner Medley forced that turnover.
See McHenry coming back in. Morrow sits down. Sam Frederick also on the floor. See the turnover story. Both teams considering really the pace of play. That's not bad. 7-5.
Well, and also you get a turnover like that if you're Georgia Tech. It goes out of bounds. It's a dead ball turnover, and you still get to set up your full court press. So it's one that's really not going to kill you in the long run. Come on.
Ledbetter. Oh, floater. Ledbetter. A factor off the Maryland pine.
Another in a long line of players from Allegheny Community College who's come here to Maryland, and more of a combo guard, so he can score the ball.
Jack lets it fly. He was fouled. No whistle. Paul Hewitt can't believe it.
Well, you know what? You're not going to get that call, you know, because you're fading away from three, and there really wasn't.
You're right.
Yeah, it's just not a play you're going to get.
Muhammad stays with it. Out of bounds. Saved beautifully by Garrison to Hayner Medley. Seconds remaining in the opening half. That was just too quick a pass from Ledbetter. Hayner Medley.
And he was excited because Hayner Medley was, because he had Jarrett Jack right on his back, and I thought if he could make that catch, like a Brett Favre pass from about 5 yards away.
Bowers back on the floor. Beckway sits down. Morrow looking to come back onto the floor, replacing Frederick.
This is one of those games, Mike, when you look at the box score at halftime, you're likely to say, this is why Georgia Tech has struggled some this season. They miss a Marvin Lewis type of player when Bonham is a non-factor.
Or a guy sitting over there in street clothes who's a senior in BJ Elba.
Absolutely. Well, more stress is put on them with the loss of Elba. No question about that.
Now we'll go against Dickey. Talk about the 3-3 record, and again, this is a team that was in the top five at one point. But when you get into league play,
that's the big number right there, too. That 20% shooting. I mean, they're just so comfortable in Atlanta shooting the basketball. But then when they get out on the road, and you rely on that, when it's not there, it really becomes an issue.
Well, that was some brick by Ledbetter. Only 66% of the stride. But he's been a factor since coming in off the bench.
But, you know, in fairness to him, Tim, it's only his ninth game. And it's only his ninth attempt from the free throw line. So when you don't get there, I mean, that was a pretty nice stroke right there.
So what?
When you don't get there a lot, I mean, it was Gary Williams. That's how he got out of his, you know, he's a 58% career shooter in college himself. But he only got to the line once a game, so you don't get a rhythm.
Morrow not there. Muhammad using the glass. McHenry trying to tip it through. As if there's a lid on the hoop for Georgia Tech in the closing moments of the first half. Trailing by 10. Timeout, Maryland.
Oh, you're right. Gary Williams really can't give a hard time to his guards about free throw shooting, can he?
Well, coming up next, I think the breath of fresh air in the ACC, Seth Greenberg's Hokies of Virginia Tech. Who would have thought they would have four wins before the end of the month of January? They take on Duke at Cameron Indoor. Ron Thulin and Dan Bonner standing by to bring you that one. And Jamon Gordon has just been outstanding for Virginia Tech. And, of course, we know of Williams and Redick and what they mean collectively to Mike Krzyzewski.
Well, and who's got the longest winning streak in the ACC right now?
I believe that would be Seth Greenberg.
Five games in a row. I mean, just what a great start for Seth and the Hokies. And should be a terrific game. I mean, talk about coming into Cameron Indoor Stadium with full wind in your sails.
Sure. I mean, this is a club that most people thought, along with Miami, would really struggle coming into the ACC. The thing you love about Virginia Tech is they play well enough to be in a position to win late. And that's really all you can ask for.
Yeah, I think Seth gets them down to that last minute or two in one or two-point games, and they've really come up big.
Nice defensive overplay by Muhammad. Got into the passing lane. Jack will hold it for one. Could be a very big swing going into the second half.
They say a three here would be a big lift for Georgia Tech. They tried to set up that little flare screen that they run to get Morrow a look down the stretch.
Opportunity missed that time for the Yellow Jackets. Painter Medley. He just has a feeling, and so does this crowd, that every time he launches, it's going to be a Drano. Tech shot 37% from the floor, including 1 out of 9 from downtown. That problem is really the principal reason they're down by 10. Let's go to Dwayne Ballin.
We did a good job. We're working hard, and that's what counts. We're pretty good when we play hard.
And you also, you're not only great defense, but you're out-rebounding them. You're holding them to 37% shooting. Very little going wrong.
Well, they got a couple late in the half for scores they put back, and we have to hold them to one shot. They're really good, and they're a great offensive rebounding team.
Thank you, Coach Williams. Gary Williams, Maryland Terrapins leading at 44-34. Now let's go to Mike Goldberg, Larry Conley, and Perry Clark for our ACC Sunday Night Hoops halftime show.
Dwayne Ballin, thank you. thank you very much. Entertaining first half, to say the least, guys. Welcome inside our studios, the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show. He is the vet, Larry Conley. He is Perry the Predator, Perry Clark the coach, number 22 Georgia Tech. They trail by 10. Here's the real thing. We knew we weren't going to see B.J. Elder, but how about Jack and Bynum? 5 points combined. Bynum, 3 fouls, played only 7 minutes in the first half.
Yeah, but Perry, I'm going to tell you something. The one thing that I've noticed in the first half of this basketball game is the fact that Maryland was able to contain Bynum, who is averaging 29 a game his last 2 games. So they've done a pretty good job defensively.
They have, but I think the key is obviously Gary Williams. I think since last week, he has turned that thing up another notch. He's gotten in those kids' heads. They're playing better defense. They're running. They're pressing. They're getting after people. That's Gary Williams.
And even he acknowledged it to our Dwayne Ballin. When we play hard, we're pretty good. And they've been pretty good in the first half of this game. Coming up on the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show, they are somewhat of the best of the best, at least we think. But how many others should be bewared in the Big Ten Conference? The Big Ten, we discuss it in depth next on the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show.
Today, Alien versus Predator, with an all-new beginning, never before seen in theaters. Alien versus Predator, only today on DVD.
You're ugly, son of a...
I've been telling everyone that Hooters is football. Well, it's playoff time, so get on down there. They got the coldest beer, the prettiest girl, and the best wing.
If you can't make it to the big game, watch it at Hooters with us, because Hooters is football.
On Sunday, February 6th, every Hooters is giving away a 32-inch TV from LG Electronics. Hey, and don't forget, you got to be present to win.
Bye.
Hey, can I have those wings to go?
See you at Hooters.
Electronic four-wheel drive. Vehicle stability assist with traction control. And an available navigation system with off-road tracking. The 265-horsepower Acura MDX gets hearts in the right place, even if you're not.
Critics have made their choice. USAtoday.com calls Fable a wonderfully open-ended and deep adventure. And the Spike TV Video Game Awards named it the best role-playing game of 2004. Fable, rated mature.
Honey, how are you? Good. How are the kids? Oh, that's wonderful. No, I just think we're going to make an early night of it. Yeah, Daddy's so tired, he's already asleep. Uh-huh. Okay, sweetheart. Okay, good night. Kisses.
The human toll of the tsunami disaster has affected all of us.
And we can all do something to help. Please visit usafreedomcorps.gov. Thank you.
ACC Sunday Night Hoops is presented by Staples. That was easy. And brought to you in part by Alien vs. Predator. Available on DVD today. Yeah.
They boast the best, the unbeaten Fighting Illini. Michigan and Purdue battling. Purdue looking for their first Big Ten Conference victory.
And they were able to pick it up today, and they had a tremendous shooting day in Mackey Arena. They shot 52% from beyond, or had field goal percentage. And today, Gene Cady got a big win. He had a better hairdo and got rid of his scowl.
Yeah, there you go. And the scowl was gone, at least momentarily. 5-13, unbelievable. Boilers avoid their worst start in the Big Ten since 62-63. To the Big East, number 19, UConn, on the road at Notre Dame and another fantastic finish.
Notre Dame has been involved in two very, very close games. It's a steal right here by Marcus Williams. Mike Gray said, what else can happen? He misses the layup, then gets fouled, and Notre Dame goes to the line, knocks down two, solidifies the win.
Remember we had told you that the four of the five losses for Notre Dame had come when they had a lead under 10 minutes remaining in the game. And as you look at the Big East standings, how about the UConn Huskies? They are very human, Barry Clark.
Well, I tell you, they're struggling right now, I think mainly because of their transition game, and it's really, they're not getting the easy baskets, but I think the key thing is Villanova, they're really surging with a great win against Rutgers over the weekend.
Let's stay and talk about the Big East for just another moment here. And, Vet, is it surprising to see UConn struggling, and are you surprised that Boston College is still unbeaten?
Well, no, I'm not surprised that they're still unbeaten, but I don't think they're going to stay that way. This is a club that's going to have some really tough times, and Perry, as I look at their schedule going down the end, they've got some really tough road games coming.
I tell you what, they have two really tough tasks. One is at the rack against Rutgers that I think is really going to challenge them again, and they have the Syracuse team coming up later.
Yeah, it is a great bit of cannibalism going on in the Big East, as we have seen also in the ACC. And the cannibalism continues at Comcast. The junior Nick Kaner medley, 13 points to lead the way in the first half. This is the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show.
With faster acceleration than a BMW 325 XI and an Audi TT, the all-new Hemi-powered Jeep Grand Cherokee conquers the road like a sports car. And with our exclusive Quadra-Drive 2 four-wheel drive system, it conquers everything else like a trail-rated Jeep 4x4.
Now, when you buy three or more medium one-topping pizzas from Domino's, you get them for just $5 each. That means pepperoni guy, mushroom guy, and sausage guy can each get their own pizza for just $5. Hey, who invited I'll pay you tomorrow guy?
Domino's 555 deal is back. Buy three or more medium one-topping pizzas, and they're all just $5 each. Only from Domino's. Get the door. It's Domino's 555.
Told you that with an Adelphia digital video recorder, you would never watch TV the same way again? We were talking about how, with the touch of a button, this little box can pause and rewind live TV and record programs without tapes, so you can watch whatever you want, whenever you want. You'll watch TV differently, but you'll still basically just sit and watch it. Enjoy the very best of digital cable with Adelphia. Get, watch, do what you want.
Thomas is extremely curious. He came to us and said, Mom, Dad, you need to get me hooked on phonics. I want to learn how to read. Hooked on Phonics has so many different components in it. It really works, and people say, wow, he reads so well. And we say, it's Hooked on Phonics.
I read a book every night before I went to bed.
Call 1-800-556-2836 for the Hooked on Phonics $29.95 risk-free trial offer. If you don't see dramatic improvement in your child's reading in 4 weeks, send it back for a full refund.
Welcome back to the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show. Maryland doing a great job on the boards at home. They lead at the break. And Maryland, the only ACC team to appear in the last 11 consecutive NCAA tournaments. Game two of our ACC Sunday Night Hoops doubleheader, paced by Carlos Dixon and Xavier Dowdell. Virginia Tech 4-2, just a game behind number two Duke in the ACC standings. Game two, number two Duke and Virginia Tech. And we'll have more of our halftime show in just...
It's about that time again. Taxes. But the friendly folks at Cashland have given them somewhat of a makeover, made things quicker and easier. Bring us your refund check and have cash in hand in minutes. Or you can start at Cashland and have us prepare and file your taxes. Then collect on your refund in as little as a day in cash. Taxes may be forever, but the wait for your refund shouldn't be. Call Cashland for details and locations. It's another way we're your cash carryout.
These two sweaters are identical, but the one on the right has a lower price. As you can see, A low price beats a high price every time.
Roger, it's 2 o'clock in the morning.
Texas Pete hot sauce. It's the bottle with the cowboy.
Also try Texas Pete Buffalo.
Code Red. I'm being pursued. I'm procuring a getaway car. Pronto. I need a car. Now.
Sure, but you'll need insurance.
No problem. I'm going to eSurance. I can buy my policy online instantly.
You're gonna have proof of insurance from eSurance?
Quote by print. Instantly at eSurance. If you're on the go, you've gotta have eSurance.
Get your quote at eSurance.com or call today. 1-888-eSurance.
Fifth Avenue Flea Market is at 3200 Arlington Road, just off Interstate 77 and Exit 120. With 3 acres under roof and over 300 vendors all on ground level, Fifth Avenue Flea Market has bargains not found anywhere else. Fifth Avenue Flea Market is open every Saturday and Sunday from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and features the snack bar with refreshments and light lunches at great prices. There's bargains at every turn. Fifth Avenue Flea Market, 3200 Arlington Road.
Yes, I am still the cook.
The best damn sports show, period. Weeknights on FSN.
Welcome back to the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show. Georgia Tech trails by 10. Ishmael Muhammad leading the way for GT in the first half. 10 points, but just 3 of 10 from the field. And really, that's the score. You look at Will Bynum, coach and vet, coming off a great performance of a career-high 30 points against Wake. Goose egg, scoreless in the first half at Maryland.
Yeah, and not only that, Jared Jack only has 5 points. And if those two guys only have 5 points between them, Georgia Tech struggles.
You know what? If I'm Gary Williams, don't change a thing.
Yeah. Hey, he's got the mojo going right now, doesn't he?
Absolutely.
And they're doing a great job on the boards as well, as we talked about. Jared Jack and Will Bynum combined for 53 points in the win against Wake Forest. As you guys said, 5 combined in the first half here. Getting set for the second half from College Park, Maryland, where the Terrapins lead by 10. This has been the ACC Sunday Night Hoops Halftime Show.
Out of gas?
Yeah.
Dodge Grand Caravan. The only minivan with stow and go. Another minivan first from Dodge.
Daddy just had to get a motorcycle, didn't he?
Funny, huh?
Grab 0+, 0% financing plus January bonus cash for total savings up to $7,500 on Grand Caravan.
Advance Auto Parts.
It doesn't take a degree in engineering to know that your car needs regular oil and filter changes. That's why we're ready in advance with brand names you trust. Castrol, Valvoline, Pennzoil, all in stock at ready-to-go low prices. So bring it on. We're ready in advance.
For the best parts, people, and brass, we're ready in advance.
Now open until 9 p.m. on Sundays.
So, how's the new job, Steve?
It's Mark, sir.
And you know that, Dad.
What happened to Steve? I like Steve.
More refined, more impressive. The redesigned Camry XLE. Now that's moving you forward.
Do you want me? Do you want me?
Listen up! Two hot deals! Get them now! At Best Buy!
Come and get me!
America's unofficial holiday starts with the Super Bowl 39 pregame show in HD. Next weekend on Fox.
ACC Sunday Night Hoops is presented by Staples. That was easy. And brought to you in part by Toyota. Moving forward.
That's what we're going to do here at the Comcast Center. Half number two of game one of our ACC Sunday Night Hoops doubleheader. Maryland up by 10 over Georgia Tech. Tim Brando along with the G-man, Mike Jaminski, and Nick Kaner-Medley absolutely picked up right where he left off against Duke the other night.
Yeah, you can just see the confidence continue to roll over. Had 13 first-half points and doing it in a variety of ways. He got this team off early offensively, 11 quick points in the first 10 minutes, knocking down a couple of threes, able to get out in transition where it's tougher to guard, and also in that flex offense, posting up inside one of two double-figure scorers for Maryland.
Take a look at our Elon statistics, and look, the number of three-point shots made versus not made, I think, is a catalyst, and the rebounding story is also crucial.
Well, I thought that Maryland would have an advantage there, and also at the free throw line, 12 of 16 to 5 of 7. But the thing that jumps off, Maryland did a very good job defensively, Tim. Georgia Tech only shooting 37%, but Tech only has three assists in the first half, and they are second in the conference in that category, so they are clearly out of whack.
Will Bynum begins the second half playing with three fouls. He took the collar in the opening half. Luke Fincher got two fouls, sat down. He only played 5 minutes. Also a non-factor in the game. Gilchrist can't hit. Kaner-Medley.
Talked about the athleticism of Kaner-Medley, and Schencher looked like he had the block teed up.
Jack, right into a double team. You know they want to get Bynum an open look, if at all possible.
And McRae is not giving any help at all. He is just shadowing Bynum wherever he goes on the floor.
Schencher trying to work pick and roll. McKinley is open for three. A much-needed three-pointer against North Carolina on the road, Mike. They were 3 of 17 against North Carolina State, collectively 2 of 15. Tonight, they're now 2 of 10. They're shooting 15% on the road in three ACC games.
And, you know, even though Anthony McHenry knocks that down, I think given the players out on the floor, that Gary Williams will live with him consistently making that shot as opposed to Jack or Bynum taking the three.
Vincent hits the rebound off the Kaner-Medley miss. Bynum, nice bounce pass to Fincher, and they need more of that.
Fincher's just got to stay on the floor and try to keep out of foul trouble if possible. And let's also look and see if Bynum, you know, when he knows he hasn't scored, when he starts to hunt his own shot. He did a nice decision on that play, getting the ball into Fincher on the two-man game.
4 points for Big Luke. Gilchrist off the bounce over Muhammad. Oh, and a nice follow by McRae, who got away from Bynum.
Right, that's where McRae's length also pays dividends. Bynum just neglecting to block him out. Looked like he was trying to leak out on the play.
McRae reaching in, gets some of the arm of Luke Fincher. Let's go over to Dwayne Ballon.
Tim, I just talked to Paul Hewitt a few moments ago before the half started. He said that his team is actually getting decent shots. They're just not going. And as far as the defensive changes by Maryland, he shrugged. He didn't think that was really affected them. It's just they have to hit shots. And he says, let's be honest, Maryland played a great half.
They did. Bynum had as open a look as he's had all night. And Drew Iron.
Well, that has clearly been an issue with this ball club on the road. And it's, you know, the coach can get you looks. The players have to knock down shots. And Georgia Tech on the road has not responded.
2 of 11 now from downtown on the night. Well, that last miss by Bynum. McRae was a dump down to Bowers. He wasn't ready for the pass. And again, maybe thrown a bit too hard. Jack leaves it for Fincher, wave it off. On the pass, he's fouled.
But it didn't look on that play, Tim, that Bowers had his hands ready. So I'm not going to let him off the hook. And if you're a big and you're going to get the ball and have a chance to score, it's your responsibility to catch it.
Garrison picked up the foul, his second.
The foul is on number 4, Travis Garrison, second on the team.
Fincher works over Bowers. Well, they're trying to take advantage in the half court of that matchup. Fincher over Bowers.
And Fincher's done a nice job of receiving the basketball with Bowers on his back.
Looks a little more like the Luke Fincher we saw in the NCAA tournament last year.
Well, calling for it. And, you know, Bowers got the initial seal there. But then you see Fincher really get into his body and drive him across the lane. And that gave him about 6 to 8 feet to work with and catch inside.
You and I had the good fortune of seeing Luke play a great deal last year and into the tournament. And his confidence simply grew. And in the early rounds of the NCAAs, he had to play big for them to win.
Well, and the numbers are not that different, but it hasn't seemed to me that Schencher has been as dominant this year as he was down the stretch last year. And I think we're seeing that. We're seeing Georgia Tech try to make an effort to get him involved.
Hayner Medley missed a chippy. That was a beautiful pass, too.
In traffic, Opikwe, the last to touch it, as McHenry was trying to take it to the hoop. Dwayne Ballon has more on Big Luke.
Timmy, I asked Luke before the game about what you and G-Man were just talking about. You know, let's be honest, you're not as much a part of the offense as you once were. And he said, you know, he just wants to win. And he admitted it was different having two guards like Bynum and Jack, who move the ball around, dribble a lot, and he doesn't get the touches as much.
That's an excellent point, because, Mike, you touched on that with me before the game got underway. With B.J. Elder not playing, it's a different chemistry for Luke Schencher to deal with.
Right, and Elder doesn't do much off the dribble. He's a catch-and-shoot guy, maybe one bounce and into his play, and it is a lot different.
Garrison taking it right to Mario West, and he'll pick up the foul for Georgia Tech.
And that's probably going to be one of the bigger issues later in the year when and if B.J. Elder does return, West picking up his third foul. So oftentimes you have to get team chemistry back when a player of that kind of influence returns to the team. Obviously, he means a lot to this team.
No, I mean, you lose a guy. I mean, he's been an all-league performer throughout his career. Talked about his ability to shoot from the perimeter, and especially in the half court, he really makes this team much, much better.
Garrison gets the free throws. They're 14 of 18 as a team.
There's BJ. Playing the role of assistant coach for the next few games, it appears. Jack. Censure the follow, and Big Luke, the Shaggy of the ACC, has become a real go-to guy here in the second half.
Well, it's amazing what happens to a center inside that he starts to feel like he's a part of the offense. They clearly look at trying to get him involved, and then these other areas elevate.
Garrison, a three.
Well, technically a big, but Travis Garrison likes to play on the perimeter, a 39% shooter from the three-point line.
Yeah, he's almost launched 20 shots from downtown, so he has a face-up game. Those that have compared him to Jamar Smith forgot that he was really more of a face-up player. On the campus at College Park, Maryland by 10.
There it is. There what is?
The Harley I almost bought.
I love that color. Is that a...
Black?
Black.
It's black.
That almost looks great.
I can almost hear that big V-twin.
Mm-hmm. Almost won't get you there.
Tired of paying those high interest rates on your credit cards? Why not consolidate them into one monthly payment at a great low rate with an eLoan home equity line of credit? It's easy. Apply today at eLoan.com.
Silverado has better resale value than Ford or Dodge. That's why it's the right truck. The official truck of an American revolution.
You enjoying your sub?
Oh yeah, Bob. I love the way you spoil me.
Considering Quizno's new turkey sub with mountains of turkey, lettuce, and tomatoes, all oven toasted to perfection, is just $2.99. Spoiling you has never been easier.
You know, Bobby, you're so good with money, and you're looking very hunky.
Well, I have been working out.
Come try Quizno's new oven-roasted turkey sub. It's just $2.99 every day.
Just $2.99 every day.
Quizno's. Toasty.
Maryland still leading by 10. You know, during the Terrapins NCAA championship run in the 01-02 season, Juan Dixon and Chris Wilcox teamed up for this spectacular dunk from midcourt. One of Wilcox's fond memories. He talked to us about it.
It was close to the end of the game. Time was running out. And Juan got a steal and threw me an alley from half court. And then I got a dunk. Coach Williams was mad, like, come on, you going to make that play at the end of the game? You know, but it was great. You know, we came out with the win, so that's all that matters.
I believe Coach Williams would still say the same thing. You're up three. You've got the ball. What if you missed the dunk?
There are very few players, maybe Stephen Blake, maybe Juan Dixon, who's gotten a hall pass on that play. But it helps to have a guy like Wilcox who can go up and get that lob.
Right. Although I will say this, the emergence of Wilcox that season was something to behold. And without him, they would have not claimed the national title.
All right, what about his departure afterwards? But that left is still, I think people out here thinking he had at least a year to go in Maryland.
Right. And that's what happens so often when you claim the brass ring. Jones trying to run the curl. Tough pass. Should not have made it.
Bynum blows past Jones, and let's see if that gets Will on track.
Right, that's what you do. I mean, that mistake had so many things about it. One, you try to force something in the middle when there was nothing there, and then it might light the candle for Will Bynum, a guy who had not scored up to this point.
Jones, nice cut. A little redemption on the back door. Beautiful pass from Taylor Medley.
And that flex offense, the back cut to Will Bynum got lost.
Chincher, still no double team, rejected this time by Abitre. Out of bounds to Georgia Tech.
Here's the look. You'll see him out there and then back cut inside, and Will Bynum getting hung up on it. There's the good look, and that's a great pass inside by Kaner Medley.
West had an open look, turned it down. Bynum inside to Muhammad. McHenry for three. Air ball.
Gilchrist pulling up. Not there. West rips down the rebound for Georgia Tech.
Well, Mario West has seen his role expand in the last few minutes, and he has given nice help off the bench.
Chincher with a nice pass. But then the foul as Mario West took it to the rack.
Chincher, and that's a nice find in there. A tough pass, too. You got the double team coming in, and Mario West with the cut right down the lane. Weak side of Maryland's defense not protecting that backside.
Two fouls on Nick Kaner-Medley. Mario West at the stripe.
Just a couple games with a hip pointer, but there you see nice production off the bench for him.
I think what Paul Hewitt really wants to see, particularly from guys like Morrow, West, guys coming off his bench, some productivity in road games. And here's Anthony Morrow, as we mentioned, without him hitting some critical threes at a time when Georgia Tech had been besieged with foul difficulty, they may have not gotten to overtime against Wake Forest.
Well, it's tougher. It's easier to get production out of West. He's primarily a defensive player. He's going to get a lot of his points inside off of garbage and getting out on the run. Morrow is the guy I think that's going to have to work into it as far as getting his three-point stroke down on the road.
Well, Jared Jack plays 20 minutes since. They try to get something out of their offense without him on the floor. Bynum. Tough pass. Made in the air. He was in no man's land.
And Bynum got whacked pretty hard on that play. I think Paul Hewitt may have a right on this. Watch this coming right at you. And McCray or Gilchrist there. They had a lot of contact on that play for no call.
One thing to have length, but to get away with that contact, that's quite another. Jared Jack played 43 of the 45 minutes the other night. Kaner Medley can't hit. Chincher the rebound.
He played all 20 of the first half, and Paul Hewitt wanted to give him a quick blow, but he'll come onto the floor in just a moment, the next dead ball.
That last shot by Kaner Medley, one out of frustration, not really involved in the offense here in the first 5 or 6 minutes.
And then trying to jump stop, and again a lot of contact. Out of bounds, 2-10. Will Bynum trying to penetrate, and and then dish out, running into roadblock after roadblock.
Well, he's, you know, I think Timmy's better served. If he's going to go in the air in the paint, he better look to score. Because he's going to get himself eventually into trouble if he goes up in the air and tries to make plays.
Muhammad. Morrow tries to follow. Another loose ball. This one picked up by Mike Jones. Out to Gilchrist.
McCray for three. Garrison trying to run it down. I believe they may whistle him out of bounds. They did.
I think Chris McCray has been a little bit of a disappointment for Maryland this year, especially from behind the three-point line. He's a capable shooter, but only at 26% this year. Really struggling.
0 for 3 tonight with McCray. Peter Medley will come in on the next dead ball for the Terrapins. Muhammad lost it on the way up. Getting credit for rejection, but he really had lost the ball himself. Chuchu the follow. Timeout taken by Georgia Tech after the made basket. And Paul Hewitt wanted a foul called as well.
Muhammad started it, and Big Luke finished off.
Critics have made their choice. USAtoday.com calls Fable a wonderfully open-ended and deep adventure. And the Spike TV Video Game Awards named it the best role-playing game of 2004. Fable, rated mature.
Alien versus Predator. With an all-new beginning never before seen in theaters. Alien versus Predator, today.
You've got friends, you've got beer. The trick is, A, never confusing the two. B, having plenty of both. C, always having something to drink to. Life beckons, and you're holding the key.
Stronger denim. More comfortable. Relaxed fit. Wrangler 5-star premium quality denim. Wrangler, real comfortable jeans.
Hey Teddy, can you come in here and do some rebates for me?
Sure.
Actually, sir, my biological dad, who I haven't seen in 20 years, just showed up. And he really wants to take me for ice cream, so...
Teddy,
yeah.
You know we have an easy button now, right?
We have an easy button?
When it comes to rebates,
Larry,
Dave, everybody has an easy button. It's called Staples. Just go online. There's no clipping, no mailing, no hassles. What's easier than that? Staples. That was easy.
Maryland leading Georgia Tech 55-48 on ACC Sunday Night Hoops. Number 52, the legendary Buck Williams joins us now. They love you in this house, my friend. You're honorary captain tonight before the game, and the place erupted.
Yes, you know, I guess their parents know me when I played here. I know these young kids, and I know Buck Williams. We did a good job of faking it.
You know, you are part of what has become one of the great programs and great stories in college basketball, the Maryland basketball program. What does it mean to you to see this now, a national championship, and you were part of the foundation?
Well, you know, Gary's taking the team to another level, and, you know, we got very close for many years, but I think the key is that the game is really kind of changed. Across the country, and now you see Syracuse, UConn, Maryland, teams like that have a chance to win a championship now.
Now you played with a friend of ours, Mike Jaminski, who's on this telecast. Now, be honest, Maryland Duke, what do you remember?
Well, all I can say about Mike Jaminski is I made a lot of money off Mike Jaminski, Ralph Sampson, and Cam went down to Cleveland. Those guys got me into the NBA because I played so well against them.
Buck was a teammate of G-Man's. Thanks, Buck.
Thank you.
G-Man.
Yep. But he doesn't have an ACC championship, does he?
Touche, G-Man.
I tell you what, I was fortunate. I played with two Hall of Famers in my career. Charles Barkley is one of them, and Buck Williams is the other one. They are both going to be in Springfield someday.
Chinchin answering McCray to make it 57-50. I saw Charles earlier this week. He told me to remind you that he knows you.
A big play makes it happen inside, and it's 59-50. Pace of the game really opening up now. Made baskets usually helps in that role. pressure working on Garrison. That's going to be a push on Travis. Timeout, 11:23 remaining. The Ballad of Buck and G-Man when we continue.
Wish I could go to California.
Why don't you?
Can't leave all this.
Thank you.
Introducing the all-new Dodge Dakota. With the only V8 under 20,000 and best-in-class torque and towing of over 7,000 pounds, why not take it with you? Now grab 0+, 0% financing plus January bonus cash for total savings up to $5,100 on Dakota.
Well, it's been a pleasure, Craig.
You're leaving us?
Yes, I'm going to be working at Anderson's just up the street.
Anderson's? That's a shame.
Turn your back on us, would you? After all we've done for you.
The rules of the London underworld. Learn to live by them. Rated M for mature.
Southwest at 23 clicks per hour. Winds at 85 knots.
You have to keep going, never letting up, no matter how much better you are. It's what has driven Toyota to be the best. It's what's kept Toyota Camry America's best-selling car. Now through January 31st, get a new Camry with 1.9 financing or $600 cash back. Or lease a new Camry LE for just $229 a month for 36 months with only $1,399 due at signing. It's a great deal on a great car. That's Toyota, moving you forward.
Leads by nine. One of the banners hanging from the top of the Comcast Center. Williams, obviously, milestone after milestone. He passed Terry Holland and in career ACC victories, just got past Bobby Grimmins, for whom the court is named at Alexander Memorial. And we asked Bobby to talk about his friend, Coach Williams.
I'm really proud of Gary. He's a good friend. I really enjoy playing golf with Gary during the off season. I got to duck a few times to make sure some clubs don't hit me. But Gary has a great program. He's a Hall of Fame coach. Two Final Fours, of course, the national championship. And I was so happy for him last year getting his first ACC tournament championship.
Reason to be proud for sure. And, of course, Bobby was the first to wave the pom-poms in San Antonio when Georgia Tech got to the national title, and he's endeared himself to that man, Paul Hewitt, in a grand way. In fact, Bobby would be the first to tell you Seth Greenberg's first road victory in the ACC came on his court.
Got there for McCray. Coach Greenberg and company awaiting at Cameron Indoor Stadium for game two of ACC Sunday Night Hoops.
Jack lost it out of bounds. I think he felt the ball had been deflected. Goes back to Maryland.
Even though it's him, he made a bad decision on that play. And that's the one thing that Jared Jack, I think, is struggling with this year. He comes into this game, 76 assists, 61 turnovers, and that's just not a good enough assist-to-turnover ratio for a point guard. And he should be much better than that. Only one assist tonight for Jared Jack.
Gilchrist inside to Bowers. Working on Rashawn Dickey. Leaves it for Kaner Medley. Oh, he rattled it home.
I don't know of a player in this league right now playing any better than Kaner Medley.
Well, offensively, you may put Guillermo Diaz up there. And right now, Maryland's pressure defensively rattling Georgia Tech two consecutive turnovers.
There's a veteran team that's shaken on the offensive end, and Maryland's defense has a lot to do with it.
McHenry with the rebound.
Jack. Nice adjustment, rejected by Gist. McHenry's foul. Goes against Kaner Medley.
It's We talked about the athleticism of James Gist. Now, Jared Jack, we talked about his strength. He couldn't elevate on this play, so it's a little bit easier for Gist to come in, but nice timing by the freshman.
Three on Nick Kuhner-Medley.
His third, sixth on the team.
16 foul at the halfway mark of the second half.
I think Gist and Bowers may be nice counterpoints to each other out on that front line together.
They certainly offer a contrast in terms of defensive matchups.
Matchup what they do, and also, Bowers can be that guy that you can throw the ball into on the low post and then let Gist kind of roam on that on the weak side of the glass.
Mario West in the game now for Ismail Muhammad. 61-52. Down on the block, but unable to do it. Georgia Tech defending well, and the shot clock under 10. Gilchrist, nice ad-lib, right off the glass. He has a dozen.
Tough shot, also like shots that he was making in the ACC tournament last year. You've got to have a point guard, Tim, who can, at the end of the shot clock, create his own shot. And here it was. Those two head up against him, and he just blew past Jared Jack.
A little aggressive on the defensive end. He picked up the foul. Two on John. You see, already 17 fouls. Maryland, with this much time remaining, already in the bonus, could really be a factor if Georgia Tech is to get back into this game. They're really not out of it. They're only down 11. You look around and you say they've been really outplayed in every facet, but they've maintained contact.
And that's what, when you're searching and struggling for the road, Will Bynum has not been a factor offensively today. You've got to find a way just to hang in there. We talked about Seth Greenberg and Virginia Tech hanging in at the end. That's what you have to do on the road.
Towers, Schencher, Stuckey, all weather.
It has been a different Luke Schencher in the second half in this game. He came out, was much more aggressive offensively. And this is a fine play, just going up against Bowers. Went up straight, kept his arm straight, and made a nice block.
10 points and 4 rebounds for Schencher, 8 of them coming in this half.
So Kuhner-Medley really trying to get the ball against Mario West.
The interior defense for Tech has really improved.
Gist rejected by Schencher. He got a hand on that one, out of bounds off of McHenry. 5 seconds on the shot clock.
Tell you, Paul Hewitt's made some nice defensive adjustments in Tech's interior defense.
Ryan Schencher, again, has been much more active on both ends of the floor.
Gilchrist. Jack gets the rebound off the deck.
Stop and go pull up. That's the fact, Jack. Get it in and get your team close. The lead is down to 7 with a timeout.
Well, I think, Tim, what happened on that play, you get an end of the shot clock jumper, and I think Maryland was a little stunned on the play. They were slow in transition. Jarrett Jack understood that, pushed it up, and made a nice play.
Luke Schencher has just been the force that you really would like to see him become.
Well, it was, he had foul trouble in the first half, so it was ineffective there, but they tried to relight the engine here in the second half, and they did a good job of getting the ball to him. And I think he's just become more active on both ends of the floor as a result of it.
The thing that you have to really like about Luke Schencher's game is that he does allow it to come to him. I mean, a lot of guys, if you sit for the last 15 minutes of the half, it's hard to get back into the flow of a game.
Well, by definition, he kind of has to in the post. He's not a guy who can't go out and create his own shot. And, by definition, Georgia Tech has to look and make a concerted effort to get him the basketball.
Critical sequence now for Georgia Tech. Defensively again, Gist and McCray that time trying to force it out of bounds. Bob Donato and Carl Hess will collaborate to determine which way it goes.
Tech gets a possession arrow and they have to call a jump ball, so they will get the basketball. And Gary Williams incensed. How could all three of you not be sure? That's his point.
Carl Hesla letting Gary Williams vent a little bit right now.
Well, the officials have to do that. That's the order of merit when you're in that situation.
Right, that's usually an indication of I might have missed that.
Yeah, exactly. And of course, Gary Williams will remind them of just that. Hynum, back by the play. Well, that was a hard foul. Now, don't forget, this February, NASCAR on Fox returns the 47th running of the Great American Race. 43 drivers in the fastest, fiercest, most high-powered sporting event in the world. It's in high definition at 5 o'clock Eastern time, 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern, I beg your pardon, in high definition.
Fortunate foul by Chris McRae on that play. He could have bothered Bynum. Instead, he bailed him out with that hack from the back.
That's his fourth foul. Sterling Ledbetter and Abikwe are back on the floor as Bowers and Gist sit down. And McRae also on the bench. That was a critical defensive sequence, and now the score is closer than it's been at any time this half, and for much of the game, down to five. Mario West with the pilfer.
Boy, his sole job on that possession was to keep the ball out of Gilchrist's hands. John got it back once, but then he came up with a huge steal, and Mario West continues to make an impact on this game.
An 8-0 run for Georgia Tech. And now it's a one-possession game with 7:44 remaining. Coming up next, ACC Sunday Night Hoops double interaction continues. J.J. Redick will be at home in Cameron Indoor Stadium leading the Blue Devils against those feisty Hokies from Virginia Tech. And boy, if they played big, Jamon Gordon and company, along with Carlos Dixon, the lone senior for Seth Greenberg, is perpetual motion. And they have been the surprise story in conference play with 4 wins already as they head to Duke. Seth Greenberg, maybe, at least for now, you had to vote the coach of the year, he would probably get mine. If you look at the standings, how meaningful that matchup is. Virginia Tech now tied for third place in the ACC.
Again, good defensive work by McKinley inside.
7:24 left. Tech on an 8-0 run, and you're watching ACC Sunday Night Hoops presented by Staples.
I like my men strong, smart, sexy, and a safe distance away from my stuff. Come on, guys, it's time to face skincare like a man. Introducing a new line of skincare from Gillette, the people who know a man's face best. It's as easy as wash, shave, protect. You see, as long as you stay a safe distance away from my stuff, I just might stay dangerously close to you. Gillette, the best a man can get.
Thanks to our 5-5-5 deal, that's 3 pizzas for just $5 each, everyone can get exactly what they want. It's changing the way people order pizza.
3 pizzas with whatever I want. If I want olive, I can order olive. If I want pineapple, I can order pineapple.
But you order 3 pepperoni.
I feel change.
Domino's 5-5-5 deal is back. Buy 3 or more medium one-topping pizzas and they're all just $5 each. Get the door. It's the 5-5-5 deal.
We'll be right back.
boxing returns to FSN. Super Bantamweight champ Oscar Larios defends his title against Wayne McCullough on a special live presentation of the best damn sports show, period. A 12-round brawl that promises to be one of the fights of the year. It's not on Showtime. It's not on HBO. It's only on FSN. Larios versus McCullough plus Ward versus Cost on FSN.
Welcome back. Maryland leading by 360-360. Tim Brando along with the G-man Mike Kaminsky. And boy, Georgia Tech's defense, particularly the interior, has been suffocating.
Right, in the half court, but I think what's gotten them back in this game, they've extended it, and Maryland has not dealt with that pressure very well. They've turned it over on a couple of occasions, and you talked about keeping it close. All of a sudden, a three-point game with 7 minutes to go.
If you can maintain contact, not playing your best on the road, that usually bodes well for that mini run.
A big play, yes, and a foul.
That pressure had gotten Maryland out of their rhythm offensively, and Nick Kaner-Medley was really, they kept the ball out of his hands, but on an out-of-bounds play, this is exactly what you want if you're Gary Williams, to have that execution. We talked about Abekwe getting the score on a basket in a similar situation down in Durham this past week.
Abekwe with 13 points and 7 boards. So when you're playing at home and your lead is in question late, I sometimes believe the pressure shifts to the home team.
Take that pressure.
I think we've noticed it, though, Mike, lately in the ACC with some of these bizarre finishes across the league in the last couple of weeks. Jack for three. Chincher gets the rebound. Right back up and rejected by a big play. And again. And Paul Hewitt can't believe there was no foul call.
Ledbetter. Well, it's being allowed on both ends. There's no doubt about that.
It's been consistent. You know what? The reason why Chincher doesn't get that call, he never had his feet underneath him. They were two real wobbly shots, and he's not going to get the benefit of the whistle.
Needs to go up strong.
You got
to
get a base. If you have a base and establish yourself and go up strongly, most times than not, you'll get that call.
Backdoor move, trying to get the ball to the interior. Tech has denied it. Gilchrist. Long rebound, taken down by Abekwe. Ben McCray sitting with 4 fouls. That's an offensive foul. They're getting Abekwe picking it up. Had his arm extended, and Bob Donato whistled it.
He felt like he had McHenry on his back, but a little too overzealous right there. You have to move your body to keep the defender there, and he had the hook inside. Good call by the referees.
We should mention, and it's true, officiating crews have their own game plans coming in. And these two teams like to get up and down the floor, and they've allowed them to play.
Thing you ask for is consistency in the game. As a player, it's your responsibility, I believe, to adjust to that.
Chincher really getting the respect of Maryland now. They're doubling him. Jack, tough shot. Muhammad trying to explode to the hoop. Rebound to Abekwe.
Not a lot of second chance opportunities for Tech.
Jack has struggled tonight. He's 3 out of 13, and Muhammad picks up the foul on Gilchrist.
There you see, man, you got the foul, Tim, but the versatility of Ismail Muhammad, being able to dog Gilchrist full court like that, and also he's been the guy primarily responsible for guarding Kaner-Medley as well.
And by the way, that's another reason Paul Hewitt wanted to get Sam Frederick in before the ball was inbounded, but could not. One of the reasons why Georgia Tech probably going to do well in the NCAA tournament, regardless of their conference record, is the way they match up, the athletes that they have at every position.
Well, and that guy, you know, McHenry, who can guard 4 different positions out on the floor.
Oh, Muhammad just bolting past Terps and then allowed the chippy to get away. He'd love to have that shot back.
I don't know if he's as effective driving from the right side of the floor, Tim, as he is coming in from the left.
Dwayne Ballon is standing by with another Terrapin star.
Timmy, the stars are out for the Terrapins tonight. They love these guys. Juan Dixon, of course, leading them to the 2002 National Championship. You had 33 points against Georgia Tech. You know how difficult it is to play against these guys.
Yeah, they're a tough opponent. You know, Georgia Tech, they're playing extremely well this year. They finished the year off strong last year. They got a big win against Wake Forest recently, so, you know, we're just trying to follow up with the big win we have against Duke, and hopefully we get the win tonight.
Speaking of that win against Duke, we happen to know that you and Steve Blake went into the locker room and talked to the players. You and LaRon Prophet also before the Duke game. Right. Now, was the Duke victory because of what you said?
No, I wouldn't say that. You know, we just tried to come in and show the guys support. We knew it was a big game for us. They were struggling a little bit. Steve Blake practiced with the guys that day. And after practice, we just told the guys they got to believe. You know, they got to play with a lot of pride. You know, we've done a lot of good things here when we was at Maryland, and we just want to let the guys know that they have our support.
Well, good luck with the Washington Wizards.
All right, thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot. Juan Dixon, they love him here, Timmy.
Yeah,
Number three.
He's been instant offense at the next level as well. And we talk about being an extension of the coach. Juan Dixon played with an attitude befitting Gary Williams, coach of guards.
Well, I think he's one of the great character guys that this program has had. We've had a couple of them on the air, Buck Williams as well. Really represent this school very, very well.
Frederick picking up the foul, and now Tarver will check in for Schencher. He leads the game for the first time. He's played very well, a difference maker, really, in the second half of this game as Georgia Tech has made their run and at one point closed it to three.
It's interesting that Paul Hewitt going small with Frederick, Bynum, and Jack out on the floor.
Ball is kicked by McHenry and a break for Maryland. They'll get a fresh 35. Gilchrist will trigger it in. Kaner Medley, McCray, Abikwe, Travis Garrison, all on the floor for Maryland. Excellent man-to-man pressure there from McHenry.
I see the matchup and see if they get it to Kaner Medley with Jarrett Jack on him. Not out that far. Jarrett Jack has the advantage.
Now the switch. Gilchrist with the clock winding down to 10.
Small unit for Georgia Tech has got Maryland pushed out.
If you're going to run out of time, he'd like it to be in his hand. Oh, the iron unkind to Kaner Medley.
And even with that small lineup, able to rebound effectively.
Jack in traffic to Tarver. Missed an easy one.
A huge miss, especially on the road. You're struggling a little bit, and you can't afford to let layups slip away from you.
You can see the frustration on Jarrett Jack's face as Tarver missed that easy one. Oh! Kaner Medley.
There's the there. Now see, 30 feet from the basket, Jack has the advantage in the lane like that. Kaner Medley can play over the top of him.
Bynum trying to will his way to the hoop. McCray has Kaner Medley with him, and he didn't get it to him. Gary Williams can't believe he didn't. And the reach on Frederick. Muhammad and Schencher will come back in. 3:12 remaining in an 8-point game. Can't beat them outside, go inside. The world of Nick Kaner Medley.
It's about that time again. Taxes. But the friendly folks at Cashland have given them somewhat of a makeover, made things quicker and easier. Bring us your refund check and have cash in hand in minutes. Or you can start at Cashland and have us prepare and file your taxes. Then collect on your refund in as little as a day in cash. Taxes may be forever, but the wait for your refund shouldn't be. Call Cashland for details and locations. It's another way we're your cash carrier.
For a completely un-fast food experience, try Cece's, where you can treat yourself to all the fresh pizza, pasta, salad, and dessert you want for just $3.99, along with a staff that will actually make you feel welcome. Cece's, we're going for perfect. But we can't speak for everyone.
Code red. I'm being pursued. I'm procuring a getaway car. Pronto. I need a car. Now.
Sure, but you'll need insurance.
No problem. I'm going to eSurance. I can buy my policy online instantly.
You're gonna have proof of insurance from eSurance?
Quote by print. Instantly at eSurance. If you're on the go, you've got to have eSurance.
Get your quote at eSurance.com or call today. 1-888-eSurance.
MAC College Hoops hits high gear on FSN Ohio. The Toledo Rockets have liftoff, and they want to rise to the top of the MAC. But the Miami Redhawks want to claw it out in the paint. Toledo, Miami, Thursday at 8 on FSN Ohio.
Welcome back there. As you see, our Staples game summary. Kaner Medley keeps on keeping on, but Chincher turned it up a notch in the second half to help Tech get to within three. The three-point barrage has evened out. Well, not really. They've taken more shots from three, but they haven't made enough, and I think that's really the key.
That's a huge key, and it's been Georgia Tech's inability now in three road games to hit from downtown with 2-of-14. And for Maryland to outshoot them in that category is a big advantage for the Terrapins.
Tech scoreless in the last 4 minutes and 32 seconds, and they cut it to 63-60 at that point. Ahmed gets the foul away from the basket, again trying to check Gilchrist.
Well, this is what it's kind of the thought that Tech had against Wake Forest. They threw 5 different defenders at Chris Paul, and it just wore him down. And I think physically, Gilchrist may be able a little bit better to handle Muhammad, but still, that takes its toll on anybody. You have primary ball handling responsibilities.
Defensive for offensive substitutions being made as Tarver comes back in and Chincher sits down. Well, the mismatch would be inside Mario West, Chincher, Kaner Medley. Been unable to find him. A big way. Excellent rebound by West.
The crowd wanted a carry on the dribble. That's rarely called. Muhammad, again, just almost pressing when they take it to the hoop. Trying too hard.
Well, he's either on that play, you've got to draw contact or go up and dunk the ball.
Jack and Muhammad are a collective 6-for-29 tonight. And the big play is fouled by McKinley. Well, Georgia Tech will have, if this score holds up, their fourth loss before the month of February. Doesn't get any easier, does it?
Hey, you could say that about anybody at any point in the season, like in this league. At Duke, at Clemson, NC State playing a little bit better. And then at Florida State, where it asked Wake Forest how tough it is to go in there and play.
Well, again, a reminder. I mean, this is a team last year that made it to the Final Four and to the championship game, having finished 9-7 in league play. So, I mean, that's the world of college basketball today, particularly when you come out of a league like this.
Coach Chincher returns to the other tackles.
Muhammad. Yes, and a foul. That's the explosiveness that you have come to expect from Ismail Muhammad.
I just think he's so much better working either in the middle of the floor or on the left-hand side where he can get to that strong hand. He's really struggled from the right-hand side, but when he can catch and shoot and go quickly like this, he is very tough to contend with.
A foul on 25.
Well, the help came way late by Bickway.
And Chincher actually did a nice job because he sealed Garrison from coming in and helping him play as well.
Muhammad for one.
Here they are, 5 down with 2 to play, a 2-possession game.
And the pressure, full court pressure that Maryland has had a lot of trouble with in this second half. And Gary Williams very upset with his ball club.
The Terrapins call a 30-second
Terrapins, of course, with that big win against Duke. When you win a road game like that, it does give you a credibility across the country that catches the eye. Clemson, Miami, Virginia Tech, and then Duke and the return visit against North Carolina State.
We'll begin talking in the not-too-distant future about the advantage some teams have without having to play a round robin, without playing a second time. As an example, Wake Forest does not play Maryland again.
Let's look at Gary Williams, I think, upset with his team on that play. They should have expected after a free throw to get some full court pressure, and Garrison really took the ball out too quickly, and he had nobody to throw it to.
Gray on the deck with four fouls, and Muhammad trying to force it, realizing that McCray had four, trying to induce the player control foul, and now Ishmael has four. You see, Georgia Tech's defense, you see where they rank in the conference, and it's gotten them back in the game tonight.
Well, and you look at that, Tim, and I think the most important number is the opponent's field goal percentage, because that's remained consistent in league play and non-league play. But you look what they give up in conference to opponents, 79 points per game.
McCray, a perfect 5 for 5 at the strike tonight.
I get you the
wheel.
Yeah. I got right here.
The lead back to 7. Against Gilchrist.
Well, you look at him, Chris McCray averages 2 steals per game, and we talked about his length, Tim, and it's served him well on that play. Mr. Long Arms, Will Bynum has had trouble with him individually, and then on that play, you're right, that was a poor decision by McHenry, just a lazy pass, and then McCray pays it off at the other end.
Those are 4 big points for McCray in the last 19 seconds. And he had been in foul difficulty and really not playing well in the second half up until that point. Schencher leaves the game. Mario West reporting for duty.
And right now, if you're Maryland, you have to be locked in on the fact. Well, first of all, you've got a 40% free throw shooter, although he's been solid tonight. You've got to block out, get the basketball, and then expect that there's going to be full court pressure after it.
They're very important right now. 72-65. The pressure from Georgia Tech. Full court. Gilchrist fouled by Bynum as he was reaching around. Don't forget, coming up next, Cameron Indoor Stadium. Ron Thulin, Dan Bonner will have it for you. ACC Sunday Night Hoops Game 2.
Interesting to see in that game, Tim. I think the big X factor in that game is Sheldon Williams.
Yes.
Because Virginia Tech does not have any wide bodies to contend with him down low.
I'll tell you who played very well the other night at home, and it was the first time I had gotten to see them, because when we did the North Carolina game back in December, Colvin Collins was not available. He does offer some help in the interior, but you're right, he's not a big body, strong body, but very explosive player.
Yeah, no, and hit the game when he shot against NC State, so he's the guy that can go to. Remember we did that game, and we came out of it thinking, well, I don't know where Virginia Tech's wins are going to come from here.
Right.
Oh, yeah, right.
This is a problem for Will Bynum tonight. He got 3 early fouls and was never really into it. 74-65, 3-possession game. Georgia Tech needs to score in a hurry. Bynum for the tray. Big one. Timeout.
That keeps them in it. Just maintaining contact as they have all night. 74-68. Well, Sunday, February 6th, one of the biggest names in all of music will be performing live during television's most watched event. Don't miss Paul McCartney in the AmeriQuest Mortgage Super Bowl 39 halftime show, Sunday, February 6th, only on Fox.
That's amazing about scorers and the mentality that they have. You have to have a little bit of amnesia about you, you know, and you've got to put behind the prior 39 minutes, and Will Bynum said, I got the ball in my hand, I'm hot, let's see what happens here, and he drained it.
Well, we know this from watching the march in March last year by Tech. He's got no problem taking the big shot. We found that out in the tournament. Their road through Nevada, Kansas, all the way against Oklahoma State with the game winner there, too. See the timeout story.
Powers getting that pass, and now they can spread the floor. Paul Hewitt does not want them to foul him. He wants them to play straight up. There's the cut.
That's what happens when you get everybody spread out like that and you're trying to play man defense and position defense.
Jack takes it to the rack and he took an extra step.
I think now you've got to start fouling if you're Paul Hewitt.
You know, I do believe that the after effects of double overtime had an influence, at least on Jarrett Jack's play tonight. He does not appear to be himself. He's been heavy-legged. They played 20 minutes. You notice Paul Hewitt took him out for a brief period early in the second half as Tech made their run to get back into the game.
And there's also there's a pressure and another level of fatigue that comes with playing at home and in front of people. You know, you want to do well. You put that pressure on yourself, and sometimes it's a positive but can also be a negative.
Thing to remember about certainly have a stoppage in play. 76-68. I think they're waiting for Mario West. We do not have an official timeout, but they have a full minute to come up with a new player anytime one has fouled out. So they're utilizing it as a timeout.
And, you know, given this game and how it's played out, I think if you're Georgia Tech, you almost have to assume that you're not going to be shooting threes well, and you have to attack in other ways, at least early, until you find some rhythm, and then, you know, make your emphasis inside out and work that way.
Well, that being the case, Mike, you can honestly say, had Luke Shinshier been the factor in the first half that he was in the second, it would have made all the difference.
And Paul Hewitt's decision after two fouls to take him out of the ball game.
By the way, how do you feel about that? I know Skip Prosser exercises that rule as well.
Well, we talked about it. I think what you have to do is I wouldn't have a blanket philosophy on that. It depends on the player, and frankly, I would want my players to learn how to play with a couple of fouls. You know, I might take them out for a little while, but I don't think I'd sit them for the whole half.
How about Muhammad saving that one in the air? Bynum again. Boy, Ishmael Muhammad, it was as if he was shot out of a cannon to come away with that rebound and then kick it back out, and again, it's a two-possession game. 35.7 remaining.
So, how's the new job, Steve?
It's Mark, sir.
And you know that, Dad.
What happened to Steve? I like Steve.
More refined, more impressive. The redesigned Camry XLE. Now that's moving you forward.
I like my men strong, smart, sexy, and a safe distance away from my stuff. Come on, guys, it's time to face skincare like a man. Introducing a new line of skincare from Gillette, the people who know a man's face best. It's as easy as wash, shave, protect. You see, as long as you stay a safe distance away from my stuff, I just might stay dangerously close to you. Gillette, the best a man can get.
77-71. Nick Kaner Medley leading the way for the Terrapins. Tech was only 2 out of 14 from three-point range, but they've gotten a couple from Bynum here to claw them back in it. Down by 6. 35 seconds left. And the quick foul given up by Jack on McCray. And unfortunately for Georgia Tech, he has not missed tonight. But they're looking to just conserve as much time as possible.
Well, and time and clock do funny things to free throw shooters. But obviously, if you're Maryland, you want to have the ball in either Travis Garrison's hands at 85% or McCray at 91%.
Chris McCray shooting 2.
This is one of the few players that Gary Williams ever told to shoot more. He wanted him to become more aggressive from an offensive standpoint.
And they want him to, again, I'll refer to the point in the first half about your 91%. Why not try to get to the free throw line as much as possible? I mean, Tim, say you take 8 shots a game there. You get 7 points if you shoot your average. And then you're a couple of layups and threes away from an 18-point game and first team all ACC.
Yep. McCray, 8 of his 16 coming in the last 1 minute and 20 seconds. Bynum. Long rebound. He followed it. Comes away with it and dumps it off to Jack. Morrow on the wing. Not there. Still struggling to find it from the perimeter on the road. Young Anthony Morrow. And that should do it.
And actually, John Gilchrist fell asleep on that play because he didn't block out Bynum on the three, and Bynum able to recycle it and get another shot for Georgia Tech.
We can update the standings now on the basis of this victory for Maryland. They move to 4-3 in the conference. Georgia Tech drops into that group with Florida State and North Carolina State at 3-4. We should congratulate Leonard Hamilton on that elusive first road victory.
It was a huge win going into NC State, coming on the heels of their win up here. So you talk about those strange surroundings, but this is a big loss for Tech. I mean, their fourth loss and not even halfway through the conference schedule.
And you and I will see Florida State against North Carolina next Sunday in Tallahassee before Super Bowl Sunday evening.
Well, this is another defensive effort that Gary Williams has got to be pretty pleased with now. 2 games.
Very important win for them, 79-71. For Dwayne Ballen and Mike Jaminski, Tim Brando saying so long from College Park. Let's now go back to our Atlanta studios. Mike Goldberg, Larry Conley, and Perry Clark.
Well, guys, thank you very much. Welcome into our ACC Sunday Night Hoops studios in Atlanta. Alongside the coach Perry Clark, the vet Larry Conley, Mike Goldberg, game one in the books, and number 22 Georgia Tech falls at Maryland. And Larry.